Okay, so this is fourth part of the video and we continue to discuss the reasons, the autosomal dominant recessive X-link related to the calcium and the phosphates. Okay, so one we have already discussed in the previous one, the video number 3, and now in this fourth one we can talk about the other reasons related to calcium and phosphate deficiency. So X-link we have discussed, and now the autosomal dominant. So autosomal dominant hypophosphatemic rickets. Okay, now this one is less common as compared to the X-link hypophosphatemic rickets that we have discussed in the video number 3. Okay, so do remember, this is less common. The more common one was X-link. Now why this happens? There in that video 3 we have seen what was the mutation, where was the problem basically. Now this patient of autosomal dominant hypophosphatemic rickets, this patients have a defect, or you can say mutation, in the gene, the mutation in gene encoding for FGF23, similar to the previous one, but what is the difference then? Encoding for fibroblast growth factor 23, the reason, the use of FGF we have discussed in the previous video. Now what happens? This mutation, unlike your previous condition, here this prevents the degradation. This mutation prevents degradation. Okay, unlike the previous one. So this prevents the degradation of FGF. Just a moment. Okay, so degradation of FGF23 by the proteases. So final resultant will be, there is a increase in the level of fibroblast growth factor 23. Okay, so we have learned in the previous video that this FGF23, it has a function of decreased reabsorption of phosphate in the renal proximal tubule. So resultant will be, what happens is hypophosphatemia. Okay, and inhibition of the 1 alpha hydroxylase in the kidney, causing a decrease in the 125 vitamin D synthesis. Okay, so this, if I just write it down, this increase in level is going to lead to what? The decrease reabsorption of phosphate and leading to finally what? Leading to hypophosphatemia. Leading to hypophosphatemia. Okay, and along with this, inhibition of the enzyme 1 alpha hydroxylase. Okay, so this inhibition is will lead to what? Decrease in 125 vitamin D, the calcitriol basically, synthesis. It will be decreased. Okay, so laboratory findings, if you ask me, that the hypophosphatemia will be there. That is the main thing, that is decrease in phosphate. So hypophosphatemia. Other will be increased in the level of alkaline phosphatase and maybe normal or low 125 vitamin D level. Right, treatment part would be same as like your X-linked disorders. Other than that, this is your second one, and the number 3, it is same, that is autosomal recessive hypophosphatemic rickets. Basically, see what is the difference, that was dominant one and the other is autosomal recessive hypophosphatemic rickets. Now that was, the previous one was dominant and this one is recessive, that is the difference. Okay, why it is caused? It is extremely rare. Do remember that X-link most common, autosomal dominant followed by the X-link, and autosomal this recessive, it is extremely uncommon. Right, and why it is reduced now? The autosomal recessive and the dominant one, X-link disorders and the autosomal dominant one, they were being caused by FGF, and this one is due to mutation in the gene. This one is due to mutation in gene which is coding for encoding what? The dentin matrix protein. The dentin matrix protein. I don't think it is relevant or much important for us for PGME purpose, so we can skip that. Okay, so these are different kind of the causes of rickets based on their relation with the vitamin D or the calcium or the phosphate. Now there are other variants also, for example the hereditary hypophosphatemic rickets with hypercalciuria, Fanconi syndrome, dent disease. These are not that common things, but then one important